In March this year, Parliament voted to impeach MP Francis Zaake from the position of backbench commissioner after he was found guilty of indiscipline by the Parliamentary Committee of Rules, Privileges and Discipline.
Mr. Speaker, let me first finish up my matter.
I'm the one who has allowed you, I will allow you. Don't mind. Okay? The issue you are raising is not part of proceedings in this house. But there are many ways you can raise that issue. I request you, you visit my office, I will give you space on how you can raise the issue.
However, since then, the legislator has declined to hand over the Toyota Land Cruiser UG0333H, which was part of his entitlements as a commissioner. While chairing today's afternoon parliament sitting, the Speaker of Parliament, Anita Among, resurrected issues of the car and reminded opposition leadership that the car got lost in the hands of their member. Among announced that parliament is going to initiate criminal action against the member who has refused to surrender the vehicle.
We've lost a car in parliament, and the car is with one of your members, and we've been looking for that car for long. And when we act, people think we are bad. We are going to take it criminally. That's a criminal action. Thank you, Love.
John Baptist Nambeshe, the chief opposition whip who sat in for the lead of opposition, pleaded ignorant of the matter, but vowed not to take action once he received the information.
It is true, matters of national importance are not provided for in our rules of procedure. But it's also true that matters of urgent public importance, which sometimes mutate into matters of national importance, are vividly provided for in the rules. So a member may still have a leeway to raise a matter under the cover of urgent public importance.
But I want a feedback on the car that belongs to Parliament.
However, the matter has attracted mixed reactions from MPs as some defend Zaake's action to keep the vehicle on grounds that his impeachment was illegal and was challenged in court, while the others castigate the Mitiana municipality legislator for illegally possessing a government car.
You know, there are procedures. For example, commissioners are being given cars. And when you are still a commissioner, you are supposed to own that car. And right now, I am very sure the Speaker and other members may be referring to Honorable Zaake. That is what I guessed. And Honorable Zaake, as per now, is still a member of the commission. He has never been removed. You remember when Parliament tried to impeach him, he went to court. And right now, we are still waiting for the court pronouncement. So it means, as per now, Honorable Zaake is still the commissioner representing the opposition in the floor of Parliament of Uganda.
That is an abuse of the property of the government. We always blame the government. We always blame ministers. We blame ministries. But I think corruption starts with us. And I think it is a high time for the office of the Speaker and the clerk to write to that member of Parliament asking him, actually requesting him to surrender the car. That is all. There is too much populist behavior of members of Parliament, especially the 11th Parliament. Why?
Because you see, if you hold an office and you are removed from that office, unless you go to court and challenge the removal from office, and before a court pronounces itself, you go ahead and get an injunction to stop the putting into effect the process of removal from office, then you would ordinarily be required to leave the office and wait for court to determine whether the removal was lawful, and if it was not lawful, issues of either reinstatement or payment of damages and the like.
Parliamentary commissioners get security, bigger allowances and government cars chauffeured by a driver appointed by Parliament and have travel benefits. They carry responsibility of recruiting, and promoting. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the News at Parliament.